People say there are three most difficult things to do in life. One,
climb a wall that's leading towards you. Two is to kiss a girl who's leaning away from you. And three is to talk to an auditorium full of people when there's a heavy lunch meal waiting for them in 60 minutes. I'm going to try and make sure not just your eyeballs, but also your brains, your heart, and your ears are open to not just my content, but most importantly, my intent of this talk. So let's actually start with a controversy, because everything that starts with a controversy gets something interesting and gets popular. I'm here to question you, what's the most important F word in our life? And before you throw up numbers and stuff, let me go back one step and ask, is F the most controversial alphabet that we know of? Certainly not. I have a better alphabet that's more controversial. It's W. Because a lot of questions that we have to answer in life starts with a W. Why, when, where, what, whom, etc., right? So it becomes tricky that you have to answer W like that. Not just that, a lot of harmful things to humanity starts with W. I'm talking about weed, war, whiskey, and so on. So W easily takes the cue for being the most controversial alphabet. F is a poor fellow, he comes a little later, and there are some wonderful things associated with the F word. Let's figure out what's the most important F word. Is it family? All of us love family. We earn for our family and we strive for them, and it's important, but my F word I'm talking to you is a little more special. Is it friends? Who doesn't like friends? We all love our society of friends, but friends are of no use if this F word is not added. Is it funds? I've long lost interest that earning money is actually the most important thing in life. Food, of course, who doesn't like food? But many people live to eat, some of them eat to live. But food is important, but without this F word, food also loses its importance. I'm getting to the other most important F word, which is very prevalent in youngsters. That F word that people tend to lose interest as they grow older. I'm talking about that F word before you shout, Facebook. It's also become a religion these days, isn't it? And that's an important F word as a part of our day-to-day life. That's not what I'm going to talk of. Let me give you a clue. The F word I'm talking to you about, I'm giving you the second alphabet. The second alphabet is U. And before you actually throw different F words, which is non-parliamentary out here, ladies and gentlemen, the most important F word in our life I'm here to talk about is fun. Why is fun so much important? Is it the most non-recognizable word that we take it for granted all the time, saying it can be compromised for a later point in time? That's not the intent for sure. And I'm here to try and emphasize why fun should be considered the most important word in our life, not just in our day-to-day life, but in a long-term perspective as well. Let's get to a basic understanding. What's fun? I'm not getting theoretical here, but Oxford defines fun to be something which is enjoyment, partial pleasure, or some kind of an outbreak for people to try and vent out their stress. Not just this. Each one of us in this room will definitely have our version of fun that we consider. Some like cricket, some like football, and some like sport, cinema, etc. Everybody is right in our perspective saying what fun is. But there are some kids and adults and legends who've redefined fun. Just to get the context going before we move on, for kids, fun is having a jolly good time and playing around and relax with relevant kids along in the kindergarten is great fun. But for adults, fun is, you know, a DJ and going to a pub and hanging out with friends and cricket and sport and fitness and all that stuff is great fun. But I know of a lot of legends who actually redefined the term fun as globally these days, especially in the last few years. Some of these legends I know of have actually done something crazy to redefine the word fun. Some legends have taken loan from Punjab National Bank just for fun. I know of some legends who've sent car to a different planet just for fun. I know of some legends who actually played with a black buck just for fun. But you know what? More than this, I know of a country full of legends who've actually elected a president just for fun. So fun, my friends, changes from person to person, perspective to perspective. For them, it could be fun. It's all inclusive, and you can categorize which category you belong to. But let's get serious. If this is that, then tell me, why should we have fun? I told you that we often compromise for this phenomenon. Why should we have fun? Is it that critical? Let me not talk philosophical. Let me talk mathematical. All of us, the average life expectancy is supposed to be 68 years, which is roughly 5,95,000 hours that we have to live our life. If you take away the non-productive time, each of us get to sleep for about 1,98,000 hours. If you're a government employee, you get a lot more than that. But that is the general perspective. Remove that time. The childhood years, which we had great fun and all that stuff, you remove that, another lakh and 58,000 hours. You take away our daily chores that we do, brushing, mobile phone, traveling, bathing, if at all you do it regularly, is another 50,000 hours. If you remove all of that, what we are left with is just a staggering 243,000 hours, of which 40% of our entire lifetime, our productive lifetime, is involved in doing something as work, profession, what we do as a day job, how are we employed with, following our dreams or not, or getting salaried from somebody, etc. My simple question to you, shouldn't we use this 40% of our time in doing something that we love doing, adding a lot more fun to our life, following our dreams and making our dreams our destiny, instead of getting to work for somebody else to paint their dreams bright? That is the question I place before you before moving forward, saying why having fun should be your core center of your life rather than something that you look forward to at the end of the week. When I ask you, what do you do for fun at work? Most people, you know, we get lost in the rat race, and it's often said that people step into workplaces in search of a living and not just a life. Most people who are working die at the age of 25 and are not buried until they are 75. We are all in a spoke in a wheel kind of a job where we actually become slaves to our salary slips. Isn't it an important critical question to consider why fun at work should be an essential core of our being? We're too busy earning a living that life perspective fades off. Having said that, my question to you is, if I ask you, when was the last time you had fun? A majority of them will come back. We've asked that to thousands of people. They've come back and said, you know, last Friday was so awesome in the evening. I went out partying with my friends. Last weekend, this happened at, we went for a party, we played cricket and so on and so forth. My question to you, why wait for a Friday? Aren't the other days equally important that you tend to sacrifice it for somebody else and wear a different avatar of your own self at work? That's the critical question to be asked, my friends. Introspect yourself. Why wait for a Friday? Having said that, I can suggest most of us, I mean, of course, I have changed over the years, and not just, there's a long way to go. But most people, generalizing, this is how we are on a Monday morning. We tend to take our dragging steps outside our homes to try and saying, oh God, it's Monday, and what do I do going to work? This Monday morning blues phenomena is driving us nuts across the globe, and it's time that we look beyond this. And we at Capgemini have done something to transform, oh God, it's Monday, to thank God it's Monday, where to try and create a culture to make sure Mondays are the most exciting days that people look forward to work. We've got 100,000 people who are available in this country where, with Capgemini, and we thought we'll change their lives one Monday at a time. Having said that, Mondays are pretty much, we're all frozen when we get to Mondays at work. Our bodies are frozen, minds are frozen, we wear a different avatar, we look a different animal when we come to work. At Capgemini, we decided to unfreeze them, take away the pause button, and do something radically different on Monday afternoons when people enter the cafeteria. This is how it is. When employees enter the cafeteria every Monday afternoon, there's a live band that plays music of employees' choice Monday after Monday after Monday to drive the Monday blues using music as a tool. All of us love music. I formed a band called Rubber Band, and we play music across different languages, English, Hindi, Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, etc., and to try and deliver magic using music as a tool. And guess what? We've been performing nonstop for the last 573 nonstop Mondays, which is 11 and a half years in a row. For 11 and a half years, music has never stopped playing in our cafeterias across to drive the Monday blues using music as a tool. We use tools such as these, and the people who perform there are just necessarily not extraordinary talents. These are ordinary people who have an extraordinary belief in their passion. And each one of us are passionate about something, and it's time that we give our passion the seriousness it deserves. Because ladies and gentlemen, passion always should precede profession. We need to place our passion first before we take a next step towards doing something incredibly good. Yes, you can go into work, you can work as a developer, an engineer, etc., etc. But remember, Dale Carnegie said, people seldom succeed until and unless they're not having good fun at what they're doing. Have great fun, the success tastes a lot more sweeter. But the problem with India, I suppose, is most of you will resonate with it. The problem with India, before you follow your passion, each one of us are passionate about something. If we give it the time and effort it deserves, we will be able to make wonders happen. But in India, before following your passion, there is one thing compulsorily that all of us have to do, which is become engineers. Most of us are engineers by birth. Having said that, the three words that's ruined a lot of dreams are "Log kya sochenge." We've surpassed all of that. Times are changing, my friends, and we are changing with the times, isn't it? The recent Commonwealth Games, an example of how the times are changing. We are evolving with it and we are trying to put our passion first, and it's time we realize that that's the single most thing that will make a difference to the 40% of our life that is there. You'll never repent the decision that you make to actually follow your dreams and passion. Let not a moment of darkness stop us from igniting the light inside each one of us, my friends, because that light has the power to try and transform this journey into something else extraordinary. Having said that, we generally put our profession a little later and give the passion a little more time to get evolved into something else bigger and better. But it's time that we realize that that is not how the ecosystem actually has to work. We need to try and get some effort going in terms of giving the passion a time and effort that passion will try and speak of us in the rest of the 40% of our lives. It doesn't need extraordinary talent to do something awesome. We could be ordinary people. If we invest extraordinary amount of time in that passion, magic can happen. You need to step outside your comfort zone to experience that magic. Instead of closing yourself to saying, okay, my fun comes only when I go out to here, only when I take my bike on the weekends, etc. Every day, you've got 12 hours of your productive life to make that 12 hours count to do something that you love doing. Having said that, what we made as Capgemini last year is to try and make ordinary people believe in an extraordinary dream. I told you, we put their passion first and we said, come together and let's achieve something significantly awesome. And life is not just about trying to do different things, it's also about trying to do some things little differently. And imagine the power of positivity when people who believe in a concrete dream of having fun at any cost come together. This is the magic that happened. सच्ची मैंने जान गवाई है नच नच कोयलों पे रात बिताई है
with 4,276 people. You are now Guinness World Records holders.
4,270 people came together and performed the largest Bollywood dance lesson the world has ever seen at Capgemini, and we created a new Guinness World Record as a part of this. Out of this 4,200, maybe 200 would have been dancers, but the other 4,000 were dreamers, were believers, who believed that they had it in them to go and do the extraordinary, and to have the passion to go and dance to the tunes to create a world record. Remember, my friends, our success lies at the other end of our fear. Stop fearing and getting into a black hole of trying to dream, saying you're clogged into a job. Break that and see the other side. I think so there's history that awaits. This was one historic moment where we actually did the unthinkable with a bunch of dreamers. Having said that, we move on. It's just not about, as I told you, what's stopping us. It's just in our mind that there is something that's stopping me to go and give my passion the time that it deserves. Do not let that interfere with it. The moment you take a step out, I think so the world will embrace you into an ideology of fun that it's going to get extremely difficult for you to break away from it. And by the time you realize it, that 40% would have been well covered and you'll never repent that decision. My friends, invariably we are stuck when we go to work. We depend on others to try and make us happy. The previous generation, till the 90s or the early 2000s, was a very, it was a very content generation, as we could put it. People got very offended if somebody knew something personal about themselves. But today, people put everything personal about them on social media and get offended if people don't react to it. You can resonate with my story. The previous generation was a very liked generation. This generation is driven all by likes. To inflate our ego, and that is the call of nature today, and we all love our egos to be inflated by the likes phenomena, but definitely that shouldn't deter us. You need to believe that we are often dependent on our managers to try and make us have fun. Let me warn you, my friends, managers are those people who actually give a 5-star super rating for a 30-minute Ola driver and get you 2 rating for 12 months of hard work in the project. I guess many of you have finished your appraisals and have come here, which shows incidentally. But it has to begin with you. You need to believe that you need to love yourself as much as possible, because being loved and liked by everybody is a total myth. If you want to be liked or loved by one person, be a good partner. If you want to be loved by few people, be a good friend. If you want to be loved by a community of people, be a good leader. But if you want to be loved by the entire state where you belong to, you only need to sell pani puris. It's a myth that you need to be liked and loved by everybody. Imagine this exercise beginning with you. Why postpone fun, my friends? The love has to start with you. The fun has to start with you. Ideate what is important and what is your direction of having fun. The world will embrace you. We often tend to misplace this fun word with something else, but the other F words that I talked to you about actually make a lot of sense if this F word is added to it. What is friends without fun added to it? It's a serious bunch of friends talking serious stuff in life? No. Fun needs to be the essence of any magical friend's journey. When friends come together, automatically fun arises. What's family without a bit of fun involved? Remember, my friends will be a lot more important in your life if you actually treat them as close and dear as you treat family. Family will be even more important if we treat them jovial as much as we are treating friends. What's the case of food if you cannot have fun with food? You can give a guy from Chennai anything, but he'll have great fun if you show him a plate of curd rice. That, to my friend, is fun having food involved in it. So add this F word to any of the other F words, life become magical. You need not, people say that I build villas and have monies and all that stuff so that at the age of 60 I can retire and have fun. All of us in this room do not know if we'll walk out of this auditorium alive. Why postpone till 60 what you can start doing in the next 5 minutes? Trust me when I say, if you have 5 minutes, you can make your life fun. And how? If you just have 5 minutes to have fun, listen to a good song. If you have 30 minutes to have fun, listen to Rahul Gandhi speak. You're already having fun. If you have 1 hour to have fun, take a nap. If you have 3 hours to have fun, watch a movie. If you have 3 days to have fun, go on a long drive. If you have 1 month to have fun, get married. If you have 5 years to have fun, vote for Narendra Modi. But my friends, if you want to have fun every single minute, every single second of your life, learn to love what you're doing. Learn to fall in love with the aura around you, with your friends, family. Learn to sow a lot of fun in everything that you do, because what you sow, so you reap. It comes back to you in leaps and bounds, and the world becomes a lot more better place. Remember, the world has to be a fairy tale driven by dreams and excitement and fun and enjoyment, and not a scary tale dependent by salary slips. My name is Mike Murali, and I believe fun is the most important word in our dictionary and our life. Thank you so much.